WLOY Loyola Radio welcomes you and all the attendees of the National Student Electronic Media Convention to Baltimore. My name is Ben Ostrowski. I'm the local music director and production manager here at WLOY, and I'm here to introduce you to the city of Baltimore and show you some of the things to do, places to go see, visit, and eat while you're in town. And don't worry, no, I didn't forget about the music because that is what we're starting with. You're staying at the Baltimore Hilton Inner Harbor Hotel here on the city map. It's a short walk to the Inner Harbor, and there's plenty of free or inexpensive transport to get you around town. From your hotel, you can see the Baltimore Orioles Camden Yards Stadium, which is sadly quiet now. Behind it is M&T Bank Stadium, home of the Baltimore Ravens, who will be in Tampa while you're here, but we have arranged a tour of the Stadium Media Center for you guys. Along Pratt Street in front of the hotel, you will find the free Charm City Circular Tour bus, they say orange in the front display, which will take you east and west to a variety of museums and neighborhoods. Taxi and Uber are also easy. For north to south travel, you just need to walk a block to the MTA light rail, which runs south to the BWI airport and north to Hunt Valley Shopping Center, with a ton of cool neighborhoods along the way. The Inner Harbor also offers our unique water taxi service to hop to different neighborhoods and all the way to Fort McHenry, site of the battle that brought us the Star Spangled Banner. There will be more info in your goodie bags, so let's get on with the stuff to do. If you're looking for music to buy or retro games and books, Baltimore has no shortage of record and music shops, with several a short distance from your hotel. Up first, we have the Soundgarden Baltimore. Located in the Fells Point neighborhood and probably the most frequented, this local staple has a huge selection of new and used CDs and vinyl. They recently opened an attached Luna Garden Cafe with the folks from another record store, Babies on Fire, so you can grab a coffee or a bite as well. Also located in the Fells Point neighborhood, we have El Supremo Records. A few blocks further east from Soundgarden, El Supremo Records is a certified vinyl lover's paradise. A smaller shop in the basement for extra coziness, shop owner Jack Moore is very knowledgeable and has a fantastic collection in every nook and cranny. Just ask and he will help you find weird and wild music for almost any genre you need. Purdian Books and Records, located in the Federal Hill neighborhood, is chock full of retro-style video games, toys, clothing, movies, books, and tons of music. The store is also host to the Crypt of Curiosities, an attraction full of odd taxidermy, creepy, and weird objects that are mostly meant to be a bit goofy. Last on this very incomplete list, we have the True Vine, located just up Charles Street, not far from where you are. True Vine has a reputation for an incredible eclectic mix of global and experimental music, hosting intimate live shows, and is definitely worth checking out while you're here. If you have time to explore further, we highly recommend a trip to the Hamden neighborhood to check out Celebrated Summer Records, with a great selection of music, but a truly amazing and fantastic collection of underground and punk flyers, posters, and zines. A few blocks from there, you'll find Strawberry Fields, which is real digging. A massive and inexpensive collection of constantly changing records priced cheaply. Normal's Books and Records in Waverly is also excellent. We could go on, but you're only here for 3 days and you're supposed to be in session, so let me show you the places where you can go see live music at night. Baltimore has an absolutely amazing music scene, with everything from annual bluegrass and death metal festivals supported equally. From punk to hip-hop and jazz, Coltrane to Beach House, there's always great music in town, and lots of local artists defy genres to create incredible blends and fantastic live shows. We are just hitting the main venues that are fairly close to your hotel here, but there are always other shows happening. We'll start with the places you can walk to from your hotel. Baltimore Soundstage is about a 10-block walk east from the front of your hotel. Located just outside Power Plant in the Inner Harbor, this venue provides all kinds of entertainment within a small and intimate space. The size of the venue provides a great view from anywhere inside, especially from the back. Chris DiStefano, Dave East, and Heavy Metal Live are all shows coming up while you're in town. A block from Soundstage, you will find the Power Plant Live Complex, which includes several restaurants and spaces with live music. But the main attraction is top-drawing Ram's Head Live, a 1,500-cap theater with three levels. A nationally ranked top venue, Ram's Head Live presents various artists and genres, from local acts to international touring artists. Tokisha and The Rex are performing here while you're in town. Located in the Federal Hill neighborhood, the long-running 8x10 looks like a row home on the outside, but is an awesome, intimate, two-level concert space on the inside. in a fun neighborhood just south of the Inner Harbor with great food choices. The upper balcony has seating and an open floor for those that are ready to dance their socks off. Brown-eyed women will be performing while you're here. A bit further away to your north, we have the Metro Gallery. This venue is a combined art gallery, bar, and music venue, so Metro Gallery is sure to have something for everyone. Shows while you're here include Daniel Nunnally, Harakiri for the Sky, and Ghost Bath. We'll close out the could-be-much-longer list with my number one go-to venue, the Auto Bar. Located near the Charles Village community and celebrating 25 years this year, Auto Bar is the place to go to find a mix of all genres. Something is happening there every day or night with the use of the upstairs bar area and the intimate downstairs concert area. While you're here in town, they have Sunstrider, Love for Strangers, Early November, I Can Make a Mess, and more performing. Now that we've got all the music stuff out of the way, it's time to show you guys where you can go to really experience Baltimore history at its best.
Hey, it's Hope Johnson, the PR director here at WLOY. I'm here to help Ben out and welcome you to Baltimore with some more info. It's Halloween season, so let's start with a grave. 5 blocks north of the hotel is Westminster Burial Ground, dating to 1786, and housing one of our most famous residents, Edgar Allan Poe's grave. This marble and granite gravesite marks the burial site of the 19th century Gothic author who spent a good amount of his life here in Baltimore. There isn't much to see at the grave itself, but the grounds and catacombs are fascinating. For a deeper dive into the work of Poe, about 10 blocks west is the Edgar Allan Poe House Museum, the actual residence of the late Poe when he lived here long ago. A pleasant walk south along the Inner Harbor will take you to the incredible American Visionary Art Museum, which concentrates on folk art and is constantly rotating unusual exhibits by self-taught artists, setting it apart from most other art museums. The museum specializes in preserving and displaying this outsider work so that more independent artists can be recognized. It is next to the Federal Hill Park that served as a fortress overlooking Baltimore's Inner Harbor, so you will not find a shortage of things to look at or do in the area. Free Charm City Circulator Banner Route buses also serve this area and the next couple of sites. A bit further down the Key Highway, we have the Baltimore Museum of Industry. Located in an old cannery, this cool museum highlights various types of manufacturing and industry from old Baltimore. From canning to cars, there are several hands-on sections with working equipment and amazing artifacts. Fun fact, the first presidential address on commercial radio was made right here in Baltimore at Fort McHenry in 1922. Speaking of Fort McHenry, a bit further down the road is one of the oldest military fortifications on the East Coast, Fort McHenry. Located in today's Locust Point neighborhood, Fort McHenry stands at the entrance to Baltimore's Inner Harbor. The fort that repulsed the British during the War of 1812 and the source of the Star-Spangled Banner, Fort McHenry is open for guided tours, is accessible via water taxi or car, and has a beautiful park setting to spend time on the waterfront contemplating Rocket's red glare. Back on the north side of the harbor and only 9 blocks from the hotel is the National Aquarium. The aquarium houses immersive exhibits including the upland tropical rainforest, a walk through multiple-story Atlantic coral reef, and an open shark tank. And of course, it wouldn't be an aquarium without the dolphin training shows. Continuing 2 blocks east from the aquarium, we have the Reginald F. Lewis Museum of Maryland African American History and Culture, an incredible resource for information about the lives and history of African American Marylanders through themes of family, community, history, and art. The fairly new museum is reasonably priced and includes over 400 years of exhibits. Heading north from your hotel, we have the wonderful Walters Art Museum. Located on Charles Street, the Walters Art Museum in Mount Vernon is a public art museum contained within 3 buildings, featuring paintings, artifacts, and other pieces of history from the past 50 centuries. 2 blocks south, you also have the Baltimore Basilica, the first Roman Catholic cathedral built in the United States in 1821, and the resting place for Bishop John Carroll, the first bishop in the United States. And a block north, you have the Washington Monument. No, not the one in DC, which is newer. Built in 1824, hosting a 140-foot-high observation tower deck looking over the city. A mere 2 blocks west of the Walters, we have the Maryland Center for History and Culture. It is the oldest cultural and historical institution in the state of Maryland and also doubles as a library. The museum space collects, preserves, and interprets objects and material, and the library includes an incredible collection of rare books and documents. A short ride west from the hotel is the wonderful B&O Railroad Museum. This is the site of the first mile of commercial railroad in America, which you can still ride there today. The museum exhibits railroad equipment used in Baltimore and the largest collection of 19th century locomotives in the United States. The massive, restored, and stunning roundhouse is worth the trip alone. Because you have to cross some major roads, it's easier to use the orange Charm City Circulator or a short taxi ride than walk there. That's our short list of just a few of the amazing museums you can visit. Now, let's talk about just a few of the nearby tours and sightseeing options for you. I'm going to preface this section with a note that many of these places are located nearby other museums or sites we've mentioned, so feel free to double dip on your fun. Exploring Baltimore is a great way to spend the day. We'll start with the very convenient Inner Harbor area, a short walk east down Pratt Street in front of your hotel. Alongside the National Aquarium, you have several great options. Look up into the sky because the 27th floor of the World Trade Center in Baltimore offers an incredible 360-degree view of the city and harbor. For $8, you can have access to a spot with amazing views and a great photo opportunity to remember your trip here in Baltimore. On either side of the World Trade Center, you'll find a series of piers that have more great attractions. Pier 1, towards your hotel, holds the USS Constellation, the last sail-only warship built by the US Navy in 1854, and if you can catch it right, you can watch a crew run drills and fire the cannons. Nearby, on Pier 3, you'll find the lightship Chesapeake and the submarine USS Torsk, both of which offer tour access. Pier 5 offers the US Coast Guard Cutter 37 and the carefully relocated 7 Knoll Lighthouse. You may also notice a few odd white snail-like machines in the water, too. Say hi to Mr. Trash Wheel, one of several solar-powered water wheels invented in Baltimore that collect floating trash from waterways that feed the harbor. In its first year of operation, Mr. Trash Wheel kept almost 1 million pounds of trash out of the harbor. It's been so successful that there are several more around the harbor working hard to keep it clean. If you like libraries and want to see one of the most stunning in the world, head up to 17 East Mount Vernon Place to the Peabody Institute of Johns Hopkins. Begun in the 1860s and focused on 18th and 19th century texts, the collection numbers more than 300,000 volumes. This fantastic library is often considered among the most beautiful in the world, and its gorgeous 5-level, 60-foot-high atrium will leave you breathless. It's Halloween, so let's talk about another cemetery. Built in 1839 on a rural estate, now surrounded by city, Greenmount Cemetery is a historic rural garden cemetery noted for the large number of historical figures interred in its grounds, as well as many prominent Baltimore area families. Some names include Johns Hopkins, John Wilkes Booth, and Elijah Bond, who invented the Ouija board right here in Baltimore. Individuals may visit, and maps are supplied for a stroll in the park-like space. And if you ask around, maybe you'll hear a few of the ghost stories. For all of you artists out there, check out Graffiti Alley in the Station North Arts District. Spraying graffiti in the state of Maryland is illegal, except for one hot spot in Baltimore where it's encouraged, Graffiti Alley. This L-shaped alley is owned by the Graffiti Warehouse, and you can never predict what designs you're gonna see next considering how frequently it is repainted over. You see it in the background of a lot of musicians' shots, and it's always different. And if you're really interested in the graffiti scene, the Graffiti Warehouse, a studio filled with street art dedicated to local artists, is located just adjacent to the alley. The alley is hiding behind the Motor House on North Ave and Howard Street and is open to all. Baltimore is a very green city with small and large parks in nearly every neighborhood. We'll talk about just a few here. A short walk from the hotel will bring you to Rash Field, along the harbor with outdoor game spaces, a great skate park, and wonderful views. Just above it towers Federal Hill, the former defense fortress overlooking the harbor. Both offer plenty of space to run, roam, or just relax with a book or a meal. The free Charm City Circulator banner route and the water taxis will take you here if you're already out for the day. If you crave the options of a really big park, head east to Patterson Park. Dominated by the massive green space of the same name, with a swimming pool, ice skating rink, tennis and basketball courts, and boat lake. The park hosts summer concerts at its restored Victorian pagoda, plus events like a Halloween lantern parade, food truck festival, and Latino Fest. Cozy eateries nearby serve casual fare and bar food, and the Creative Alliance Arts Center, anchoring the southeast corner, has movie nights, theater, galleries, and live music.
Now it's time to get into everybody's favorite category, food. I'll be giving you guys a list of some of Baltimore's best eateries while making sure to cover as many parts of the world as possible. This city has a thriving and excellent food scene, whether you're into steaks or vegan banh mi. Pizza is everywhere, but so are wonderful neighborhood spots with Ethiopian, Afghan, Caribbean, and more styles. Don't hesitate to check online, as most of these places will now deliver through an app if you don't feel like heading out. Head east from the hotel on Pratt Street to get to Phillips Seafood. You can't come to Baltimore and not try the local seafood options. This family-owned restaurant since 1956 started here and has locations worldwide, but maintains the hometown crown for crab cakes. Baltimore is famous for its local oysters and blue crabs. If you're not filling a table and smashing them with a hammer, then you gotta have a crab cake. Continue east on Pratt Street and you'll find a Loyola student favorite, Miss Shirley's, serving great tasty twists on some of the most comforting food, with gluten-free pancakes that are seriously good, plus vegan and vegetarian friendly menus despite being classic American. Breakfast, brunch, and lunch are always worth the wait. Keep going east and turn south on President Street to find the whole dining neighborhood of Little Italy. Known for its strong Italian-American heritage and identity, this is a fantastic cluster of restaurants. Isabella's Brick Oven Pizza is fantastic, but you can't go wrong with La Scala Ristorante Italiano, Sabatino's Italian Restaurant, Amici's of Little Italy, and Ciparelli's Restaurant. Honestly, there are so many good places in Little Italy, just walk in and eat somewhere. South of the Little Italy community along the water, you find the Fells Point neighborhood with a rocking nightlife and great food. It's also home to the Soundgarden we mentioned earlier. There are probably too many places to list, but let's talk about Liquid Earth just down the street from the Baltimore Tattoo Museum. Oh, did we forget to mention that earlier? This cozy cafe offers unique vegetarian, vegan, and raw dishes and desserts, plus smoothies and blended juices. Liquid Earth is a place that focuses on the real, unprocessed food, and you can be sure that this is the only place in town like it. Okay, let's cover a few of our 5-star international options for you adventurous people. We'll hit the Mount Vernon neighborhood for a few standouts. Ethiopian restaurant Dukum is a huge favorite with an outstanding menu and extensive vegetarian options and 3 spice levels. They offer traditional Ethiopian dishes served with injera bread in a bright eatery and bar. Nearby in Mount Vernon, you'll find Helmud, one of the finest Afghan restaurants around with more than 30 years in Baltimore. Just above the Washington Monument on Charles Street, it's a good stop after a bit of sightseeing. The Helmud offers an extensive full-course menu of lamb, seafood, beef, and chicken dishes, as well as eggplant, spinach, and other fresh vegetable options. Also, their baby pumpkin dish is to die for. On the west side of Mount Vernon, you'll find Land of Kush, a tiny but fantastic Caribbean vegan soul food restaurant. From smoothies to salads, wraps, fritters, and more. Always good, just look at the line of famous folks who dropped in to eat at this tiny spot. A bit further away, but worth the trip, is the Paper Moon Diner. Paper Moon Diner offers interesting and unique sandwiches and breakfast options. The atmosphere is a fun mix of eclectic nostalgia and art. The mannequins in the bushes, walls covered with dolls and Pez dispensers, turn the place into a found object art gallery that always has something new for your eyes. And bacon milkshakes. Yep, you heard that right. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner all day long. You can order delivery, but don't. You need to go to this place to appreciate it fully. Across the street, you'll find Our House, a restaurant incubator that resembles the tastiest food court you've ever seen, featuring 10 different small shops with chefs using it as a launchpad for standalone restaurants. You'll find a wide variety of options here: Mexican, Korean, Japanese, veggie bowls, smoothies, and much more. Tons of options and a very cool atmosphere. Want to catch a movie at the Fantastic Charles Theater, our local art cinema house? No problem. Just stop in next door at Tapas Teatro for your exploration of Spain and small plates to share with your friends. A solid menu for everyone from vegans to carnivores, and you can walk through the side door into the theater for your movie when you're done. Located across the street from Metro Gallery, so you can choose between live music and film. We seriously haven't even scratched the surface of the killer food in Baltimore right now. Every single neighborhood has a great spot, some have a dozen. It's a golden age of food here in Baltimore. Thanks for watching this, everyone, and for coming to Baltimore. We know you'll have a great time, learn a lot, and meet peers from all over the country. We at WLOY Loyola Radio are thrilled to share our charm city with you and help you see Baltimore is a beautiful city with a lot of rich history and culture, and we can't wait for all of you to experience it for yourselves. We are all excited to make this a great experience, so feel free to find a WLOY staff member at the conference and ask them for their suggestion beyond this list, because there are just way too many. This is Ben
and Hope
signing off, but looking forward to meeting all of you in Baltimore very soon.